All right. Hello, everybody, and welcome to Sunday streaming. Sunday streaming? Yes, Sunday streaming. Right here on Rage Light, I am Jeff. And that's it, because everybody else is gone. John and Amanda are out of town. Kayla was ill. I'm feeling a little under the weather myself, but it doesn't matter. Doesn't matter, because I'm going to save that Viva Pinata for next time. And in the meantime, we're going to play a little Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker, because that Gamescom Ground Zeroes demo was hot as hell. Hot as hell. Oh, whiskey hell. I don't think I could do Jeff versus whiskey. I think that I would throw up, and then there wouldn't be anybody to do the stream at all. So, yeah, I just taken them all out. And so here's the thing. I'm going to try to keep a half an eye on the chat. But as you guys know, I do get somewhat easily frustrated. So if I get frustrated today, I'm going to focus back on the game. And then I'm going to focus back in the chat. And I'm going to focus back on the game, back in the chat. But I am going to be here to answer some questions. And the first question I have, while this awesome intro is going on, is... should I start this game from the very beginning, since we've never really played it on the show before, or should we just jump into my save game that's a little bit further down the line? I'm going to let the chat decide, since they're the big troopers that are here, and I pulled the old switcheroo on them, so... If my dog had any interest in playing video games, you got to believe he'd already have a show, folks. All right, well, I'm not really seeing a whole lot, so I'm going to go ahead and just start from the... From a save point. Jump in. All right, I'll jump in. All right, so really quickly, for those of you who've never played this before, this is actually like probably one of my favorite Metal Gear games of all time. As a PSP game, I thought it was just like way, way better than it had any real right to be. Whiskey Hal, I don't have the flu. I'm actually just a little, I don't know. I smoked a lot of cigarettes on Friday night, and last night I had some problems, and whatever. I have food hangover today. I don't have beer hangover. I have just straight up food hangover. So, all right, well, we're going to go ahead and... see where we are at in this storyline. Cool thing about Peace Walker is it's broken up into a bunch of teeny tiny little missions so that you can play it on the bus and shit, since it was originally a PSP game. So I got to find a soldier carrying an ID card. All right, I could do that.
To gain access to the lab, you'll need an ID card. You can get one from a guard in an orange jacket stationed in an area where you can hear Quetzal singing.
Okay, orange jacket.
To get the ID card,
sing a Quetzal's,
do a body check.
Cool. So this is a little bit down the line. I've actually got a fair amount of stuff. And let's see. So you can pick in this game, like, what, you know, it's just like kind of in Metal Gear Solid 3, you can pick like what type of camouflage you want. But I like sneaking, because it means you can sneak up on people, and then like the more equipment that you have, the slower you move. Anyway, that's enough of all that, you guys. It's a sneaking mission. It's some stealth tactical action. Sparks, I'm actually playing this is the HD version on the PlayStation 3 and the Xbox 360, and I think in a few other places. They made an HD port of this where you could actually get, in fact, I think that there was, they sold for $30 like a year or two ago, the collection where you could get like Metal Gear Solid 2 HD, Metal Gear Solid 3 HD, Peace Walker HD 4, and a digital code for Metal Gear Solid, original Metal Gear Solid on the PlayStation Network for like $30 or something like that. Oh, dude, you should have seen the shit out of me. So, one of the big things in this game, as opposed to some of the other games, is that you're building this giant army. And you want to take soldiers with you, so when you like bring guys down, you can scan them and see if they're any good at anything. He's not super good, but I can always use food, dude. So I'm gonna send him up. See ya. So for any of you guys who've been watching like all the different Gamescom and E3 coverage of Ground Zero, or of Phantom Pain, it looks like it's going to be just like a really like way expanded version of this particular game, like all the mother base stuff and all the GMP stuff. I did, Sparks. That's what I was just talking about. Is all the stuff on mother base looked really interesting. I mean, like, I really like all the RPG parts of this, where it really makes you feel more like you have a, like you're building an army than just wandering around in the jungle, than the kind of like tactical mission. Like, I like the way that they've kind of added that on, and it actually makes sense that the boss's storyline would have that as opposed to, you know, snake stuff originally. S audio, but D Dog is he's so adorable. Like, there's a part in that Gamescom demo where he's like a puppy, and it's, oh my god, it's just adorable. All right, it's been a while since I remember, like, this is one of the only Metal Gear games I've ever played in my life that has, oh shit, okay, this level has snipers. God damn it. All right, I already messed it up. Don't send reinforcements. No, it's fine. I'm going to get out of here. I mean, he's no D-horse, right? But he is a D-dog, so... I mean, the fact that D-dog has an eye patch? I'm kind of curious to know how that happened. Okay. Everybody's all riled up now. I might as well just keep going forward. Yeah, there was a part in the demo from Gamescom where Snake was like all covered up with like blood and stuff, and he was all super stinky. Oh shit. God damn it. Wow. I don't think I've ever done this poorly in one of these missions. Come over here. Next. Ah shit, I didn't even bring any rations because I don't normally. Oh no! Okay, I gotta restart this bullshit. Statchman, this is totally Viva Pinata. This is, I don't know when the last time you played Viva Pinata, but yeah, I thought that was a real, I think that Konami might have some kind of like brain problem situation on their hands, because like that Silent Hill pachinko thing. Like, I don't know how they could not understand how the community feels about PT and the cancellation of PT that more, so, or that much, because, I mean, like, to just be like, yeah, I mean, to even, I mean, I guess they've got pachinko parlors and whatever, but on the other hand, Jesus, guys, I mean, come on, like, people really, really wanted to play that PT game, and then you're gonna be like, yeah, look at all this Silent Hill 2, and it's a pachinko machine, alright. Alright. Yeah, it seems like frickin' Phantom Pain is going to be this game times a bajillion with all the different things that you can do and all the different options. I'm still not really sold on on Kiefer, on Jack Bauer as Solid Snake. Like, I love me some Jack Bauer, but I like Solid Snake more than Jack Bauer, so, I mean, you know, yikes. Hey John, how's it going? How's California? Well, John, we were gonna play Viva Pinata, but then Kayla showed up and she was immediately ill. I don't know if she just took one look at Viva Pinata and it was too cute, but she was just like kind of violently ill and then had to leave. So, where's the other sniper? Oh, there he is. Yeah, look at this motherfucker. Look at him. Doing his thing. Plus, I just, you know, Metal Gear, right? It's Metal Gear. Ooh, he's got good intel. See ya! Once you get the sneaking suit, this game gets, like, way easier.
Fulton recovery subject confirmed on board helicopter.
I'll take it. Right. I hate this area because it's just completely full of snipers and they all blend into the bushes. I should have brought my night vision goggles. Oh, see, look, there's one over there. I see you. Oh, I can't even zoom in on him. That sucks. Sweet, I know that, you know, I definitely understand the complaints against, I mean, like, I never thought that David Hayter was the world's greatest voice actor, but I'm just all for the consistency of you know, if you have somebody. It would be like if the next Uncharted game didn't have Nolan North as Nathan Drake. Like, suddenly they hired, like, I don't know, pick somebody. Who in Hollywood sounds like Nathan Drake? Like they got John Cusack or something, I don't know, to play the voice of Nathan Drake. It's like, he might do a great job, but Nathan Drake to me is Nolan North, and Solid Snake to me is David Hayter, and I just have a real hard time with that change. Especially because it's not the second game. It's like the what, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7th game or something like that. Like, just even Nathan Fillion would be a hard transition to make. Like, I don't know. I mean, Nathan Fillion's kind of got his own way of talking. So I'm a pretty big fan of just keeping it consistent. But that's just me. All right. Uh-oh. Who just saw me? Who saw me? I didn't see any guys around here anywhere. I'll try not to get into the same shitstorm that I got into last time. Oh. Oh, God damn it. Fucking snipers. All right, fine. Don't send... No, just... It'll be fine. Lazy Krogan, I haven't seen Fantastic Four. Alex, when I... The choice of Darkness 2 for me and Brian to play was just kind of looking through... Oh, God damn it. Fucking... Forget these guys. Can't be... off me, you bitch. Oh, shit. Oh, God damn it. Oh, look at all your buddies. Uh-oh. They're back. Shit. Okay, fuck. I'm leaving. I need to fight a helicopter over here. Look at all those guys. Looking for me. It was just, I was looking for a game, and I was looking through, like, lists of games that were shorter. Slightly shorter, like, stuff that was, like, a solid 6 to 8 hours, so that, you know, we weren't starting something, like, gigantic. And I remember that I had a lot of fun playing Darkness 2, that it was just kind of a fun game. S-Audio, that was the level where you fight the helicopter, yes. But I actually just did that before we started, or the last time I was playing the game, so... Oh, shit. God damn it. I'm trying to hurry way too much. All right, see you, John. God damn. Okay, you guys just... Enough. Oh, no, come on. Ah, my... Son of a bitch. Yeah, actually, S-Audio, much despite the all evidence to the contrary... You know what? I'm doing this the wrong way. I'm going to do this the right way. I'm going to go ahead and just back it up and bring the one thing that I should be bringing for this particular level. So... yeah, all evidence to the contrary. I can actually breeze through some of the boss levels in this game. As long as you're not trying to, like, capture the thing, it's fine. Like, I can beat Chrysalis really easily. I used to just grind to be able to get through it. Grind on some dudes. All right, here we go. NBG, that's what I needed. Well, when I say all evidence to the contrary, I mean that despite watching this stream and seeing me just, like, die, get caught and die a lot. Yeah. Yeah, just like, yes, R. Warden is just like Metroid. I am just that, I'm so as good or if not better at this game than I am at Super Metroid. So we're going to go ahead and just try to get through this mission without a million alerts. Get that guy. Don't see me. Don't see me. Don't see me. Let me that out. Don't see me. I'm quick. Don't see me. Do.
Is someone there?
Nobody's here. Here we go. I didn't see Pixels. I saw Ant-Man instead. I thought about going to see Pixels, but like there was like a Pixels at like 10 o'clock on the one day that I had to go see a movie, and so it was either that or it was Ant-Man at 10:30, and I decided Ant-Man. All right, here we go. Now we should be able to see these guys. Okay, I already know where these two are, and I'm not even going to bother getting anybody this time. There's a sniper. All right. I thought Ant-Man was pretty good. I think that I don't know when this happened. I think it was probably Guardians, like the combination, the two punch last year of Guardians and Winter Soldier. But I kind of I liked a lot of what I saw out of Ant-Man, but I wanted it to have just a little bit more style to it. Like I would have liked to it to have had a little bit less generic soundtrack, a little bit more, and a little bit more just like character. Like I really, really dug like all the musical choices that they had in Guardians. Oh, see, look, that's the guy that saw me before. Do you guys see him? Right there? I'm gonna shoot him in his fucking face with a fucking tranquilizer dart, and he's gonna go the fuck to sleep. Look at him there, thinking he's all sneaky. Not so sneaky now. Are ya? Who else? There's got to be another guy in here somewhere. What's my favorite snack? It is probably popcorn is what I eat more than anything because it's like lower in calories. Oh, look, there's another one. Look at him over there trying to be Mr. Sneaky Pants. He thinks he's so sneaky. Sneaky. Sneak. Oh. Okay. How about if I stand up? He thinks he's so sneaky. Ha ha, but he's not. All right. I think at a certain point, if I remember correctly in this game, you can actually develop like the Soliton radar from the original Metal Gear Solid. And then the game becomes just like stupidly simple. But you have to have like a certain number of people, I think, on your intel team. I don't know. There's all these like research requirements that you have to have. Where'd that guy go? Is he over here?
Fulton recovery subject confirmed on board helicopter.
Oh, there he is. I'll just take him regardless. Yeah. So when I got done watching Ant-Man, the only thing that I could really think of was I think I would have absolutely loved if Ant-Man had been directed by Steven Soderbergh, because I think that between the different kind of like crazy characters and the kind of heist aspects to it that would have been a really good like kind of if it was like in that kind of Ocean's 11 style, I think it would have done very well. I think it would have there's probably a couple of other people that could probably have done the same thing. I think it's just Soderbergh is the first person that comes to mind.
Fulton recovery subject
all right, I think look at this, we're going to finish a mission without me dying. Oh, man. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Okay, so let's turn on. Oh, look, there's a guy. Thinks he's sneaky. He's not. Oh, man. So, you guys, I don't know if you have this problem. If anybody else has this problem, but I went to John Rubio's birthday party last night, his 40th birthday party, which Miss Kayla was, she did that stuff up like Broadway style. St. Helian, I don't really like shake a lot of the dudes down because they rarely have anything super interesting.
Nothing here.
Oh, is there a sniper up there? Usually I'll just bag him and tag him. I mean, since you're not out in the world for very long, it doesn't behoove you to have to like carry a lot of stuff. Plus, in this game, oh shit, okay, that's the guy that's seen me. One of the things that I don't know if people understand about this game is that it's got kind of like an RPG element where, like, the more you carry, the slower you are and the easier it is for the enemy to detect you. So it actually kind of behooves you in a lot of cases. Like, there were times where I would be trying to get, like, I'd go into a map to get a guy, like, this kind of guy over and over again, where I would just bring nothing but the Fulton system and just seek you see them. Because your character could move that much faster when they got through there. The Friday night Wiener Schnitzel, the Friday night meetup went really well. We had probably maybe 15, 20 people, maybe a little bit more than that, but everybody came out and it was a real good time. It's been just hot as balls here recently. I think the summer started and it really wasn't all that hot, and then it just like kicked it up into high goddamn gear. Okay, so I gotta make sure. Looking for a guy in an orange vest, you guys and gals and ladies and gentlemen. Nope. I know that Quetzal's gonna be out here doing his little Quetzal bullshit. Where are you? Oh, there's a guy. Oh, he's got an orange vest. He's getting shaken down. There's the Quetzal sounds. Woots. All right. There's the ID card. Hold on, Miller. I'm patting his butt down. Butt pat. Butt pat. Butt pat. all right. Away you go, buddy. Whee! Do I have to, like, go back to the beginning of the map? I forgot what happens here. Oh, hey, look, a prisoner. I think that some of the, like, I don't know how many of you guys went and watched the Gamescom, like, Mother Base trailer for the Phantom Pain, but, the fact that there's, like, a Fulton recovery system that takes people through a wormhole is just, it's one of those kind of just Kojima bizarro things where you're just like, what? I'm sorry, wait, can you repeat what that does? And you just, okay, sure, paramilitary wormholes, you know, whatever you guys feel like. All right, let me make sure that everybody didn't just come back to life over here. In fact, I think Joe and I are doing the podcast this week, because we had a lot of kind of stuff that got moved around, which is going to be a little bit later than normal when we're done here, the podcast will go up. But Joe and I did the podcast. I don't think we talked a little bit about some of the Metal Gear stuff, but I don't think we talked a lot about the FOB stuff, but I really like that, like dragging a little bit of Dark Souls into Metal Gear by giving you the ability to go defend your base from invasions and, you know, outfit like your AI guys and stuff like that. I really think that it was a nice addition to the whole kind of way that things go. So, but on the other hand, you know, we're talking about, I keep reminding myself whenever something in Metal Gear just seems completely ridiculous, I remind myself, this is the franchise that has the B Commando in it, right? And the psychic commando and like, oh shit, oh fuck, oh come on, run snake, run, wait, where am I even going, over here, okay, all right, I gotta get in this lab, I really should have just taken everybody out, go, yeah, we're getting ready to have another big boss fight, oh shit. As long as I don't die here, which is very possible. Very, very, extremely possible. Now you stay down. You stay down. I'm going to patch your crotch. Oh, okay. All right. Yeah, I don't. Oh, shit. Guy's got shotguns. Fuck. This suit was not made for fighting. Run, snake! Run! Oh, God. Go. Oh, shit.
If the enemy knows where you are,
Oh, Miller, what are... Oh, shit. Oh, god damn it. Son of a bitch. Bitch.
What's going on, Snake? Report. What's your situation?
Okay. What was the most annoying boss fight in a game you played? It was probably be... it probably would have been the end, while a great fight is a little irritating. I'm going to make all these guys get on their faces this time. And I'm not going to fault anybody except for people that are in my way. And I'm going to just run and jump and do this super sneaky. The end was one that in the beginning was really difficult. I think that Ornstein and Smo in Dark Souls is a really difficult boss still. I can tell you honestly that back in the Final Fantasy VII days, I never was able to beat Ruby or Emerald Weapon. I never did that. I just got bored of playing the game before that happened. Let's see. Okay, where are these assholes again?
Once you know which soldier has the ID card, do a body check. Yep. To do a body check, first knock the
soldier. Do a body check. You guys all get down on your bellies. I don't give a fuck anymore. There's another one over there. Another one over there. Take care of all of you snipers. Oh, yeah. Asura's Wrath was pretty... That was a pretty frustrating... pretty frustrating fight. I'm trying to think... Final Fantasy bosses. You know, it's funny. Final Fantasy... 10, I remember after my friend showed me how you could grind your way to essentially godhood in that game, I beat the last boss in like 2 hits, I think. Oh, shit. No. Oh, no. God damn it. Shit balls. All right, we're taking care of this. No. No reinforcements. No reinforcements. God damn it. We have no situation. There's not a situation. It's fine. We're all fine here. Yeah, Flame Lurker is a pain in the ass. I think that there's a lot of Demon Souls bosses that are really... The Maneater is not a super fun boss. God damn it, you get over here. Oh, God. You. And I am really going to have to... I'm really going to have to concentrate on this bullshit. I'm trying to think of other people that are not from, like, Souls or, oh, shit. Okay, don't you... Here, I'm going to get the fuck out of here before you guys... Hopefully before they find that guy. I'm trying to think of bosses from games that are not in those franchises. I know that there was a few enemies in Resident Evil 4 that were a little bit, you know, a little bit rough, or at least affecting to the point where I remember them, even after all these years. I'm trying to think of other, like, just straight up hard ass bosses. Oh shit, these guys are all like looking for me. God damn it. Ah, shit. Son of a bitch. It's gonna happen again. Yep. Oh, shit. I was not prepared for this level of violence. Oh! Nope. Okay. Is that all of them? My night vision goggles are totally empty. I'm gonna shake these guys down, see if anybody's got a fucking ration that I can use. Man, Well, I don't know why I'm just having such a hard time on this mission. I don't normally have this bad of a time. There's a battery. That's useful. Alright. Nothing. Oh yeah, these are just the pop-in guards. That's why they have jack shit. Check two.
Fulton recovery subject confirmed on board helicopter.
This is all useless for me. Oh, tortilla chips. Whew. Okay, get some nachos. Okay, you guys can get out of here. Boom. Boom.
Fulton recovery helicopter is complete.
Oh, more tortilla chips. Oh my God, that's so. I don't know if this is. It might be the only game that I've ever played where I'm just like, whoo, man, tortilla chips. Oh, I can't believe how happy I am to eat these tortilla chips. All right. So let's see if we can't get through the rest of this without just completely screwing it up entirely. Probably not, but hey, give it a shot. Never can tell. Stranger things have happened. Jeff, would you like a waifu pillow? I don't entirely understand the waifu concept. Is it like Japanese for crush? Is that what it kind of is? Just like, I think that girl's real hot, so she's my waifu. Is it like wife, like more of a wifey type of thing? I don't really understand. You guys can explain it to me. Oh, look, there's something up there. So, oh shit. Pat your butt. Patch your butt.
Snake, pick it up.
And you're going to take a ride on the Fulton train. And look at that. There's some chips up there, but I can't. Oh, wait, hold on. Yeah, there we go. Oh, wait, there's another dude.
Fulton recovery subject.
I forgot about this guy.
Onboard helicopter.
Right, you get up there. There's so much conflicting information coming at me from the chat right now about what is waifu. What is waifu? Okay, good. Got some more rations. Keep me from dying just entirely as fast as I was before. Or, I don't know, sort of. I tell you what, somebody asked me this, and it was kind of way back in the, chat log. That Dark Souls 3 trailer, pretty hot. I mean, I don't know that they would release a Dark Souls trailer and I would be like, yeah, it looks like garbage. Looks like they just totally fucked it up. It's totally like garbage. Not even a fan of the franchise anymore. But it looked pretty hot. It looked a lot more. I think that I tried to make a point to somebody one time about, because in constant to a harem, love between one man and only his wife who. So, okay. I'm sorry, I'm just reading Urban Dictionary waifu definitions here. But I do think that, like, when Dark Souls 2 was getting ready to come out and people, the trailer for it came out, like, I think that if you compare the trailer for Dark Souls 2 and the trailer for Dark Souls 1, that Dark Souls 2 just looks a lot more kind of Miyazaki-y. It just looks a little bit more creative, I would say. Which is not to say that, I mean, I kind of eventually came around on Dark Souls 2, but I think that 3 just looks better kind of from the onset. Are you familiar with Bane posting? I am not, I've never heard of Bane posting before. Waifu. Dark Souls is Jeff's waifu. Yeah. All right, let's see if I can get through. This is like the next to the last one. Oh, look at this guy being all sneaky pants. Thinks he's being sneaky pants. Look at him. Oh, okay, he's still held up from when I went through here before. I guess the guards didn't come to this section and tell all these guys that it's okay. So they're just going to lay on the ground forever. and never get up. It's cool with me. I'm fine with them laying there forever. Oh, my God. This one mission has taken so long. Sorry, folks. Jeff, do you think there will be a giant dick monster to fight? I'm assuming you're meaning in Dark Souls 3. You know, who could say? Sometimes there's a giant dick monster. Sometimes there's not a giant dick monster. I'm sure that we made the jokes before, but, you know, Darkness 2, that's pretty much just like your main weapons are like Dick Monster A and Dick Monster B. All right, here we go. I think we got the card that we need, and we're going to open up the lab, and yes! Frickin' finally. Am I excited about the Batman 1999 skin and Batmobile DLC skin for Arkham Knight? Kind of, Bluezoo, but I don't really have as much... I mean, you know, like, I don't have, like, reasons to really play Batman at this point. Oh, schnizzy. It's after you beat this this guy that you get the battle dress armor. I remember now. I remember what's going on. Lieutenant Commander Armstrong, there was a giant vagina monster. It's called the Gaping Dragon in the original Dark Souls. And it was gaping and full of teeth. Greedo. What?
It can't be.
Can't be Greedo. This doesn't belong in this game at all.
Looks like death wasn't ready for you yet.
Awesome.
And who might you be?
You.
That's the only problem with this game. The only thing I don't really like.
I've been waiting. Snake.
I'm not really a big fan of these cartoon,
yes,
these comic book cutscenes.
Waiting for the one I despise.
Shit, man, I haven't even met you.
Don't move. You men and your guns. You all say the same thing.
Whoa.
I suppose you're here.
Okay.
Yes, I know. Just as I know what you did 10 years ago. Go on. Kill me like you killed her. Kill me like you killed the boss.
He should really just do
kill
it.
Kill me.
Do it.
Exactly.
Shoot me. Kill me.
Or should I say big boss? That filthy title given you as reward for murder. Do you still wear it with pride? You
Ugh.
Killed the shadowy country over the mentor who made you what you are. You brought despair to good soldiers everywhere.
Oh.
You used the pretext of a mission to kill a true hero.
You know nothing, Jon Snow.
Is that what you call loyalty? Answer me. What do you have to say for yourself?
I have to say, shut up!
She betrayed America. She stole a Davy Crockett and then defected to the other side. She used an American nuclear weapon to attack Soviet territory. The only way for Washington to prove its innocence to Moscow.
Yeah, that's the thing about this game is there's... I think it's got a lot of good gameplay. I think the story is a little... Better than Portable Ops, but... Not on par with, say, 3.
It's the truth as it was told to me.
So the truth is that you sullied the reputation of your mentor, the woman you loved most in this world, before you buried her.
It was my mission.
So that's the conclusion you came to in order to live with yourself.
What's the boss?
I think it's funny that she's trying to guilt trip him for something that was like...
I won't rest.
Yeah, like... She's trying to guilt trip him for something that, like, he did it, but, like, the boss, it was that much, way more complicated than that.
Would you like to meet her?
The boss is gone.
Not so fast.
What are you doing? No, you shouldn't, not snuff. Come on, Strangelove. That's so gross.
It's
so gross. Don't, you know.
Care for a sniff? It's only snuff. You're a cigar man.
Oof.
Well,
oof.
Smoking in there, so if you want
man.
To you best partake now. Follow me. This is my baby, my morpho butterfly. It's neither pupa nor cocoon, but an imago.
And did you program it to play like Burt Bacharach tunes? I think I think that for anybody, like, this is why I was asking if people wanted me to start from the beginning, because this just doesn't really make any sense. It's the mammal pod, obviously.
For my participation on the project, I demanded access to all information.
Also, somebody is asking, is she huffing coffee? No illegal sweet, that's snuff. That's like powdered tobacco that you fucking do a snoot of. Every operation she took part in, every decision she ever made at every possible turn, what she took and what was taken from her, her pain and her pleasure, her joy and sorrow, her life. Man, quit name dropping Cobra Unit, Strange Love. All right.
Why would you do that?
Coldman sought an MAD-based AI that would deliver
dude's
effective
nuts.
Strike against the most appropriate
even on the PSP. Is snuff still legal? I think so. Does inclusion of Joy Division in the Phantom Pain mean it's the best game ever? No, it's the inclusion of Hall & Oates makes it the best game ever. I kind of just wish they would redo this with in-game, in-engine cutscenes. They've got all of the lip sync. They've got all the audio and like sound effects and stuff. Just something that's not this like paper doll cutout horse shit.
I knew of only one person who could be entrusted with the fate of the entire human race.
What's your real goal here?
To clear her name.
Oh, blah blah yakety schmackety. It's complicated. No, she ate all the Cheez-Its. She had to be eliminated. Snuffies. Yeah, it's just powdered hot dogs that you snort with powdered chili. Side of powdered chili that you snort. That's what you do.
Really? You think you understand her feelings?
Is he okay? I was gonna say, is he crying or sweating or what? Which do you like more, the Raid or Dread? Dread, because I like I like sci-fi stuff better, so.
Boss.
Hey, boss. What's up?
Jack! Go home. I'm not your boss anymore.
I'm a robot.
Boss. Go home.
I like robot stuff now.
Complete your mission, Snake. Extinguish that.
Does she just have, like, cocaine, like, running all down the front of her jacket? Is that what's going on there? Man, we have some hot peppers over here, and I don't know what to do with them. I'm not going to eat them. Like, Jason brought some, like, habaneros over here. We're going to do the Rage Cast. We're going to do... Take them all out. Take them all out. All of them. All of them are mine. I'm going to take your car stereo. Here's your 5-disc CD changer. It's your XM radio. It's your DVD player. Your Blu-ray player. Your dashboard Game Boy. It's your NES. So I got a Betamax over here. All right, got the food processor, and they've been having exhibit like all up in this mech. Come on, lady. I've destroyed like almost half your brain by now. Son of a bitch. The nerdologist asked, did I ever played the original Metal Gear on the NES? What did you think? I thought it was one of the best games I ever played in my life, and it was what got me down going down this road in the first place. I even played Metal Gear Solid or Metal Gear 2 Snake's Revenge, the horrible. Oh, hold on, I gotta concentrate on quick time events. Ooh. Ooh. Swing, swat, grab, slam. It's like a Batman. It's like watching a 1960s Batman. Shoop. Shooper doop. Shooper dooper dooper. I'm not listening to you, boss. I'm waiting for quick time events.
It means devoting yourself to your country.
R1. Hooah.
As long as we have loyalty to the end, there's no point in believing in anything.
Snake looks like he's having some kind of like horrible bowel movement.
That's the way a soldier's supposed to think.
God damn it. See, that's what I hate about this one is that they make you, you have to do these quick time events. And then they'll give you a rating for each mission, and in a lot of cases, the rating for your mission is based on whether you do the quick time events properly. So it's like if you want to do the quick time events properly, you have to go all the way back through the mission from the very beginning. And it kind of sucks. Whoosh! Whap!
I'm defecting to the Soviet Union.
Lazy Krogan asks if I want help leveling up to get to the Taken King. Not really. I don't know if we're going to do the Taken King. And if we do, I think I would just invite Aaron over and have him log into his Destiny account, because that's a lot of work to do for a 60-minute video. And I don't really play Destiny, you know, so it would kind of just be a waste. Why was there a talking cat in Peace Walker? Is there a talking cat in Peace Walker? This is Peace Walker. Is there a cat that talks? Dr. Von Boogie, I am more than, I mean, I've been talking to Aaron. He has been out of town for a month, so we should be trying to get it back on soon. I'm really hoping that everybody gets back on, and if we can kind of keep the, you know, Joe and Sarah and, you know, Brian Salisbury, and then once Grant has had his baby, and so congratulations. I should actually say there's been a lot of congratulations. It ends up that John Rubio and Grant's new child have the same birthday, which is pretty incredible. CQC Master. 10 enemies, 1 prisoner. Yeah, Jay Zachary, I want to get Aaron on the Ragecast. It's just the thing is that guy's got very limited amount of time. Kind of like Grant, kind of like a lot of the different people that are out there. But I think that if we can kind of get everybody together, working at the same time, that we'll be able to maybe start doing some other stuff. Okay, so let's see. I need to get some. Who's? Damn, these guys are all seeing. You can go to mess hall. Lime soda. You can go to the mess hall. You can go to the mess hall. Okay, there we go. Mammoth. Angelfish has a B in intel. Woots. You know what? I'm just going to auto-assign. What's that? B in intel? Absolutely. Okay, we're just auto-assigned everybody. Boop. There we go. Oh, man, we need to do some more research. Let's see. What do I got under items? The Walkman still comes. God damn, that Walkman has taken forever to research. Lovebox, Sonic Eye, Shield, Lime Soda. Nah, let me go back to weapons. We got M16, M10. Ooh, Chaff. That would be incredibly useful right now, but Strike marker. What's the difference between these two? It's a support strike marker, and this is a placeable strike marker. Okay, what do we got? M16A1. M10 with suppressor. That's what I need. Okay. All right, now we get to do... a boss fight, which, if you guys have not played Metal Gear Peace Walker before, there's like a whole, they added, see, this is supposed to be like, kind of like Monster Hunter, right? So, in the beginning of every mission, it says, like, do you want to do it solo, or do you want to bring other people? So you can bring up to three other people with you on, like, these boss missions. I think you bring, like, one other person with you on the individual missions, which, if anybody out there, I tried doing a mission, and I tried looking for somebody to go on the mission with me, and it just didn't really work. So, I don't know if any of you guys actually out there have an interest in that. I think I would love to invite you. I'd just like to know beforehand. So, ration, curry... tortilla chips. Minus camera, Walkman. Bring the Walkman. All right, I think that's it. Let's see here. Start mission. So these missions could be like really tough, especially some of the end ones where you really have to level up a little bit before you actually do these fights, because they're big involved fights. Jeff, what is your opinion on a Ghost in the Shell live action movie? I don't know. I'm not really a big fan of. I think that, like, if you already have. Where'd you go there? I think if you've already got an anime for something that. You don't really need to. You don't really need a live action movie. You can just watch that. Okay. Let's get rid of these RPGs. Come on, bitch. Where'd you go? It's not a chopper, Miller. It's like a fucking giant flying mech. There it is. Come on back over this way. Okay. I'll tell you what, when you decide to calm down, then we'll have a proper fight. Until then, I'm just going to shoot you from a distance. As long as you... Just one. Okay. Let's see here. What will I do if Donald Trump gets elected? I will probably make a frowny face and go, aw. I mean, oh, shit. you got all fucked up. Don't like that chaff. That's right. Get another one. Come on. Go. Oh, nice. Yeah, you should engage attack mode. Where did you go? No kidnappers. Oh, God damn. Hate these things. If I had my battle dress, you'd be smoked. Actually, I just need some FIMs. There you go. What's wrong? Why are you just sitting there? Let me shoot at you. That's stupid. Oh, shit. Missiles. Ouch. I've convinced you to vote for Donald Trump so that I make a frowny face. I'll make a frowny face if you don't, if that'll keep you from doing it. I mean, you know, that's, you know, tell me what you need me to do. Oh, no. Shit. Is there another kidnapper still out here? Did that missile miss? Oh, shit. There's a kidnapper out here. Yeah, you should recall your dirty freaking kidnappers. Oh, God damn it. No time to be missing. That was bad. I'm just going to shoot out way wide. I might as well use the machine gun. Anyway. Oh, shit. Yeah, that's what I want to do, Snake. Son of a bitch. Okay. You know, you don't have to sing like that. There you go. Ha 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 ha. Alright, out of ammo entirely.
They've okayed the request for support. They're sending out a cardboard box as we speak.
Here we go. Get my stuff. No. God damn it. Ow. Okay. Ah, got some curry. Got some rockets. Whoa. What you doing there? No rail guns? Dirty pool, old man. Don't you move. Yeah! What are we doing now? Shit, it's a little too high. Ah, son of a bitch. I hate those little bitches. Okay, here we go. Son of a bitch. No, you're not. There you go. That's what I think of your kidnappers. You big lady, you big flying robot lady jerk. Come on down here. Come on, fight me. I'll throw chaff grenades. I know you don't like those. Come on. Wah! See, that'll interrupt your dumb singing. Sing something good. Oh, no. Ah, shitty. God damn it. All right. Come on. Back over this way. Oh, just two more little health bars left. Uh-oh. What happened? Okay. I don't have the surround indicator, Miller. I do have headphones on, though, which I usually don't use to play video games. Where are you at? I can hear you, you big dumb peace walker. Oh, shit! Snuck up on me! You think you're a sneaky robot, huh? Oh, now what's happening? What's going on? You get messed up. You got messed up. Y'all messed up with no place to go. Oh, shit. Shoot me in the face with rockets. It's dirty pool. All right, I gotta get another supply drop here. Wish I could pick what was in that box. They just keep dropping curry. reload this. Yeah, actually, we are going to break in just a few minutes. Probably after I finish up this fight, I'm going to take a quick smoke break. I'm going to try to chug the rest of my coffee here and try to get a little bit peppier. I'm sorry if I haven't been super peppy. I wasn't expecting. I would have maybe gotten up a little bit earlier and tried to caffeinate a little bit. Oh, you dirty, dirty robot! Come on, shoot you. There you go. Get down here. Get down here. Come on. You gotta line it all up and shit. Come on. I like when you when you're fighting the helicopter in this game, and you like you can tranquilize the guy that's driving the helicopter, and when you do that, like the helicopter comes down to a very soft landing, and then the guy falls out of the helicopter, and it's like, oh, okay. Also, how? Oh no, I know how this works, but gotta get in there. Gotta get in there. Gotta yank out all of her stereos, man. She's just filled up with just portable car stereos, and I gotta get them all out of there. Man, I could go for some really spicy curry right now. I'm doing it. Otacon, you need to shut up, or Otacon's dad, or whatever you are. You need to shut up. Pull out all the boards. Taking this one. I know. Blurg. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I know. Here we go. Chose one. And this one. This one is her memory of clowns. I'm going to take that one with me. This one is that time that we made out. Oh, got to get it. I'm going to throw that one away. And one more. Boom. Woot. All right. Well, yes, we're done. We beat the chrysalis. Is that which one this is? Or is this the cocoon? Or is this the... I don't remember which one this one is. Oh, this is the Kerbal Space Program. Bye! I thought I pulled all of your controls out, but... All right, cool. Chrysalis. There you go. Battle complete. It has a railgun. It's basically a flying Metal Gear, and they had it attack the one man in the entire world with more experience blowing up Metal Gears than anybody else. So good job, Dr. Strangelove. You really thought that one through. Great. Keep them busy for me. Carl Gustav M2 design specs rank 2. That's very important. Support strike marker specs rank 3. Oh, I thought I got battle dress for doing that.
She played me like a piano.
She tickled my ivories.
That is as long as you've got the will to do it.
I am not giving up.
No, never. I'm going to eat curry. Eat curry all day long.
Testing base for Peace Walker is 15 miles to the north of that lab.
Okay.
It's an underground facility disguised as a rock quarry. All you need to do is sneak in and destroy the AI for good this time.
Oh, wow. So it's like two or three maps, and then we're going to have another one of those same ones. But all right, folks. Well, I tell you what. I'm actually going to go ahead, and I'm going to pop off here for 10, 15 minutes. I'll be back at 4:45. So stick around, and I'll be back. Get your questions ready. I got to, like, look over to I'll try to keep an eye on the chat while I'm in the second part. I'll try to get us through more than just one area and a boss fight. So, yeah, stick around, and we'll be back momentarily for part 2 of Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker. Peace Walker, right? Peace Walker. Welcome back, everybody, to Sunday Streaming right here on Rage Select. I am Jeff. And I'm all by myself, and we're playing Metal Gear Solid 5, The Phantom Pain, as you can tell by this this view of the big shell or whatever. No, I'm just kidding. We're playing Peace Walker today. But I like the fact that you can, like, you know, just whoa, look at everything that's going on here. Look at my little, look at my base. I got, like, an office building on this one. It's got, like an ad space at the top that I could sell to somebody. But yeah, during the break, I went ahead and I got everybody all set up. I got my outer ops are running here. I got some dudes out here doing some battles. Got my research going. So let's go ahead and see what the next story mission is. Let's see what happens. Man, one fun run. I would sell my... Not mama. I love my mama. I was going to say, I would sell my mother for an advanced copy of Peace Walker, but or of Phantom Pain, but that's not true. It's not true. I love my mom. Wouldn't sell my mom for nothing. Nothing. All right, so let's go ahead and flip back over to sneaking.
Stealth. Man, I'm Solid Snake.
And we'll go ahead and... Uh-oh. Greedo! Hello, Greedo.
A Nation Reborn.
Turns out that if you don't just sit around, like, grinding for, like, going into the same mission to capture the same, like, C-level, research tech over and over again, that you can actually get through the story a lot faster.
Not too bad. You never know he was over 20 years old.
We know. Look at that gross... He looks old in his face. He's got all these, like, wispy flyaways. That horse needs some conditioner, man. No, not even for a copy of Dark Souls 3. I wouldn't sell my mom for nothing. She's my mom. She's the best.
Getting up close and destroying the AI instead.
Okay, Huey. You're so
Whatever
dramatic.
You do, I'm begging you. Don't let my Peace Walker launch a nuke. Hurry, Snake.
Hurry. I'm so, I'm going to pee myself.
All right, here we go. I think this is the area. Ooh. Okay, I'm going to go through here and try not to completely disgrace myself. But I think that this particular area, if I'm not mistaken, is like the area of Peace Walker where you can do some Assassin's Creed bullshit, where you can like caw down into a haystack. So, sliding over. Glad there isn't a stamina bar in this one. I would be boned right about now. Was there a... Oh, there's no... Okay. I thought I heard a. Oh, there he is. Okay. So I thought I heard a prisoner go, meh, meh. It's funny. Every so often you'll get a lady prisoner, I guess. And when she gets pulled up. Yeah, that's it. That's it right there. It's like Miller does this like, oh, yeah. Oh, all right. Let's see. I don't think I can actually flip over there, but I'm going to try. Whoop. Oh, okay. Or I'm just going to fall down on the ground. All right, here we go. Pick up whatever the fuck this is. Yeah, all right. Got some ladies up in this. I have a feeling that Mother Base is kind of a sausage fest. I do know that when I was playing this on the PSP, they had this option where you could just, like, recruit soldiers from different Wi-Fi hotspots. So you would, like, be in an area. You would scan the area for a Wi-Fi hotspot. And then if you found one, it would, like, generate a soldier for your base based on that. And then I found one that was a lady soldier that was, like, she was a better sneaker than Solid Snake, if you could believe that. She had, like, a higher, after sending her on a bunch of missions and stuff, like, she had a higher, like, sneaking value than Snake did. So I ended up using her an awful lot for a lot of different things. See if I can't get this other guy. Just going to take the easy route today. Wait for everybody to knock out. Takes a while with these. There goes one. What? What? You could be imagining whatever. Since you, Jeff, since you have German ancestry, do you think you would ever go to Oktoberfest? I would love to go to Oktoberfest. I've actually been to Munich before, not when Oktoberfest was going on, but I would totally go if I had the resources. I was talking to some folks this weekend about how I've wanted to go on a vacation for a while, but I just haven't really had the money to do so. Kind of goes back to that whole like E3 thing about, are you going to waste money on something when you know that you could, oh, there you go.
Go west, Snake. West.
You go west, jerk. When you know that you could use it for something that would maybe be a little bit better. So. But yeah, I've had Lieutenant Commander Armstrong says come to Seattle. I was actually thinking about my friend lives up in Denver, Colorado, and he says that you can get a plane ticket up there for like $150, like from here to Denver. And I'm thinking like, man, I've spent that much sometimes on like a really, you know, kind of decadent weekend. Maybe I'll just go, you know, go down there and stay with him for like maybe like leave on a Thursday, come back on a Tuesday kind of thing. Go up to Denver and at least cool off a little bit. Boosh. Okay, I think that's... Oh, no, there's another guy up there. I got you. I see you. You're not hiding from me. All your buddies got taken out. You were just oblivious. Now you get to go as well. Whee! Like, don't fight or anything. Don't try to cut the rope. I mean, I guess that would be pretty scary if the Fultons didn't... I mean, it probably just, in real life, just like... just kind of like gradually has you come up a little bit. All right, so let's see if I can do the... oh, shit. God damn it. See if I can do the Assassin's Creed thing here for you guys. A meetup in Denver. Wow, I don't even know how many people... I mean, I don't even know what kind of... Like, I have no idea, like, where our fan base, is most heavily concentrated. Like, as I understand, we're kind of just all over the place. All right, yeah, here we go. You guys ready? Boop, boop, boop. You ready? Here we go. Assassin's Creed crossover.
Back in the time of the Crusades, members of the Order of Assassins used what is called the Assassin's Straw Box to hide and get close to their enemies.
Shut up, Master Biller. That doesn't really mean anything. I'd be interested, actually, about why you guys, if like how many of you guys in one area, if you guys had like a little meetup of your own where it's like you could just get together and be like, yeah. I think there's one other thing that I want to get here. So, whoop. By the way, if you guys have a PlayStation or I think pretty much even an Xbox 360, like I don't mean to, I'm not like, oh, okay, just some more Fultons. Like I'm not trying to like, you know, I'm not a shill for Konami or anything. Like we talk about their horrible business practices on the podcast this week, but I think that you can go out there and probably digitally buy the whole Metal Gear Solid, like, HD collection for, it's probably next to nothing at this point. Uh-oh. No! Peace Walker! I think that's, like, one of the shortest missions in the game. Like, I think you can just run from one place to the other. Ooh. No, not the Peace Walker! Oh, shit. This is the mission. Okay, no wonder that first part was so easy. There's going to be, like, all of these, like, yeah. Yeah, like, no matter how sneaky you are, this guy sees you, the alarm goes off, and then it's like, I didn't bring any other guns or anything. Like, I should have brought a sniper rifle or something. Fuck. Fuck me! Here I am saying, like, oh, I'm not going to screw up any more of these missions. And that's exactly what I'm doing. Oh, okay. Whew. Shoo. All right. That's great. All right. Boop. Five soldiers, two prisoners, miners' residence. Not miners, miners. I'm in Delaware. Nice. Yeah, I heard that in in Denver that it's like it's still pretty warm, but the humidity is so low that your sweat can actually do what it's supposed to do by wicking away and cooling you down. It's just that you get like way more dehydrated than you would like say here, because you're actually losing moisture to the air, whereas here you just sweat and it really does nothing whatsoever. What? Get all these parameters up in combat. Good job. Shotgun ammo. Team Alpha came back. Oh, shit. I didn't mean to watch the team results. So this is, you got these little missions where you can send your guys out and they do this little, like, pew, 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 pew thing. They're like, oh, no, I got hit. And then your other guys are like, oh, yeah, here's a grenade, stupid. And he's like, ow, I'm Sailfish. My name is Dumb. And then Oven Bird? Is that what it says? Like a roasted chicken? No, Oriole, no! Kill that Oven Bird. You got shit on you. Dude, don't shoot the lav. Shoot the Oven Bird. Oh, shit. Magpie fucked up your lav. And Sparrow's got that Oven Bird on lockdown. Man, I brought you guys I let you guys have the tank. I got the T-72 with you guys, and you're not even using it. All right, fine. Skip all this. Bomb box. All right, let's send some of these. Let's send our send these guys back out for another group of missions. This is a D+. So send these guys after that. And I could send Team Charlie after these assholes. Grouper and bullshit. I got the helicopter with them. Yeah, it's funny. I was actually just telling you guys, or I was telling somebody over the course of this weekend that I would love to have some kind of meetup here in Austin when it wasn't just like balls hot. Like, I know that the summertime is when people get like get time off work and they can go on vacation, stuff like that. But Jesus, it is intolerable in this town during the summertime. Like, I wish that we could get everybody up here like in the spring or in the winter, or I don't know, even the winter. Winter's here. Like, if you come from a place that has really harsh winters, winters here are just delightful, right? It's like, you know, it goes like 30 degrees and everybody here is like, oh God, I'm going to die. And you guys all have your shirts off and shit. And you're just like, ha ha, you guys are stupid. So.
Damn it. You've been spotted by the guards.
I didn't get spotted by shit.
They take you out.
Yeah, I don't know. The spring in Austin is really nice if you if you're into that sort of thing. But survival. It mostly comes down to kind of the thing of like how much, when would be a good time to get people here when they could like take time off of work. And I'm going to try to be a nice guy here and use tranquilizers on the people and some chaff. Do I not have any stun grenades? Ration, Walkman, chips. Okay. Yeah, we'll do it that way. Start mission. Does Austin have snow in the winter? Austin has like a light dusting of ice every like 3 or 4 years when it's an exceptionally destructive and unpleasant winter. I think that for the most part, our winters would be described by any normal person from a wintry place as mild as shit. For the most part, it's fairly dry, and it's a little cold, but it's not. Like, I think it gets colder in over in Arizona. But yeah, I don't know. I mean, I kind of just wonder how much actual interest there is about, I mean, whenever anybody comes into town for Rage Select, we always try to make time to go see them. But you know, all right, so let's get some, what we got here? Yeah, there we go. Get some Metal Gear tunes on. Where's my zoom? There we go. God damn it.
We'll get a beat on you from a distance. Just because you can't see them doesn't mean they're not there.
Okay. Here we go. Who's shooting the drones? That's you guys' drone. I love the medley on the jukebox here. There we go. That got popped. Oh, shit. There's another one. Nope. God damn it. Snake. There we go. What's that freaking drone? I can hear him buzzing around my head. Dude, I can hear you, and it's irritating the hell out of me. Oh, there you are. I don't have enough ammo. Dun, dun, dun. Like, that's that theme that you guys are hearing from this medley is like this sneaking music, I'm pretty sure, from the original Metal Gear. There we go. I don't know about this part, but I know that dun, dun, part is like, that's like what they played in the very first game. Sorry, I'm having a hard time looking at the chat here. What the hell is okay? It's so weird. I'm wearing headphones, and these little drones, they sound like they're right next to me. I don't normally play with headphones, so it's just a little disconcerting. There you go. Okay, 21 of 24. Jeez Louise, guys. I have to start picking this up. Sorry, I'm trying to keep an eye on the chat, but I do have to continue. God, that's so weird. Like, the footsteps from these soldiers that are out here sound like they're right next to me. They can't be right next to me. I don't know where they are, but they're not right next to me. Oh, shit. Well, they're there. Wow, they were walking, like, right in a row. There we go. Oh, shit. Dude, jerk. Patch it down. Yeah, okay. I'll take your calorie, mate. Or whatever you got. Doo-doo-doo. I'll let him go to sleep. Anyway, Jeff, what kind of mics do you use? I use Shure, S-H-U-R-E is the brand name, and I use the Beta 58A. That's a hypercardioid mic. One of the biggest problems that I have whenever anybody comes to record at Rage Slight for the first time is getting them to keep their face all super close to the mic, because this can't... they're so good at not picking up outside... stimulus, but you just have to, that means that you just have to be like super close to him. How does slamming these guys to the ground kill them? Well, I'm shooting them with tranquilizer darts, and then when I throw them down on the ground, they're passing out, and that's technically what's going on here. Yeah, I know they've got rocket launchers. I didn't know where they are. Oh, shit. God damn it. I should not have gone the nice guy route. I should have been a jerk with you assholes, but you just seemed like such nice guys. That's a rocket launcher, dude. Come on, dude. Don't be a jerk. There we go. Oh, shit. One, two, three, and... Ugh! Oh, shit. Okay. Ow. Son of a bitch. Oh, shit. Okay. I mean, I could just run in there and murder them all, but that's not the way that you snake it. That's not the way that we do in Snake Town. Snake Town, USA. There we go. That guy's out. Where are the rest of you butts? Saw one over there. There he is. Ah, shit. So that's the tune from Metal Gear Solid 1. What are your thoughts on Steam's lack of quality control? You said you mistyped it. Is it the Steam, or you talk about my stream's lack of quality control, or is if I talk about Steam, I think that Steam is just running into, I feel like a problem that you're going to see from that you see from a lot of just like straight up retail merchants, right? Is that you know, it's hard to get into a position where you, I mean, how do you tell people, well, your product isn't good enough for our service, especially with Steam, because you can, by not posting a thing on Steam, you can essentially just lock that entire, whatever that is, like whatever game you're talking about, you can just kind of like, you can severely damage the ability of a retailer to actually sell their product by not listing it on Steam. So, like, I understand that every week I look through Steam and there's just a smorgasbord of garbage there. On the other hand, I don't exactly know what the alternative would be. Oh, shit. You guys are all bunched up. I am not a good sniper. I'm bad. Oh, shit. All right. We'll do this the old-fashioned way. There we go. What you got? Anything good? I'll take it. Hey, I need those bullets. Don't make them go all the way away. Oh, shit. Uh-oh. Ooh. Wah-ha! Hey, you're both on the ground. All right, I don't really need all these 12-gauge bullets. Oh, yeah, John. I am the world's worst sniper. I just have a bad sense of when to pull the trigger and when not to. S-Audio, I've got rations equipped, so it's get good noob, John. That's the only way I understand it. You got to use Dark Souls speak on me. So I don't have any diazepam or anything. Let's see. What we got. Oh, shit. You need to go away. This is your rocket launcher guy. Shit. Aha! Okay. What was I just say? Want quality control? You should go see Origin Store. Origin Store. Whoa! Time to. Oh, I'm like, what is this guy talking about? I didn't know what he said at first. But he said time to man some meat. I was like, whoa, okay. Come on. Oh, God damn it! I guess we're gonna kill each other at this point before I'm able to kill you. Haha, right, you junk. Where's that guy with the rocket launcher? Let's see here. We got two more. That guy's one. Rocket launcher guy's gotta be the other one. Oh, there he is. Oh, you sack. All right. We'll go over and finish him off. And then we can get into the big fight. What do you think about having a new guest for each new sequential playthrough? Asks B-Hammer. I don't know. That's not a bad idea. Yeah, I've thought about it before. It's mostly just kind of like what the schedule demands, so... Alex, you sometimes annoy me, but not always. You're just very insistent. And some days that can get on my nerves a little bit, but it's nothing, you know. I'm a bit of a touchy guy from time to time, so that's not even a big old thing. Woo! All right. Now we've got to face, I don't know, one of the biggest bosses in all of Metal Gear, if not, I don't know, video games? This motherfucker. Okay, I'm not going to have everybody asking if they annoy me. Nick Primer, sometimes you annoy me, but I'm an easily annoyed guy, so... Everybody annoys me from time to time. Grr. See, and look, he's just going to come on in here. Like, oh my god. Really? You're just going to dump it on down? Who even built this thing? This is a Dodge. Sir Wolf Chin, I'm not real fondle touchy. You can ask Kayla. You ever see Kayla and I say goodbye at the end of a stream? We touch fingers like E.T., but more emotional. Yeah, I know. I mean, why would you even build something that big and not have like a million dudes standing around it? Well, shit. See, we got a... I like the fact that it's like it's a giant tank. It's got all these guns. It's got all these missiles. It's got all these normal implements of destruction. And then it's got an arm with a chainsaw on it. I wish I had my BDUs or my battle dress. Hey, boom, look at that. Zero kills, 12 minutes. All right. Yes. Egg Primer. Everybody does annoy me from time to time. It's mostly just how I deal with it. Okay, I got my sniper rifles, got my lime soda, got my analyzer, got my sonic eye, got my surround indicator. Everybody's in combat unit. New plant got built. Look at all this shit that's happened. So check that out. Look at that. Brand new. It's got solar panels. Got solar panels, and a whole office building. Kind of like Kerbal Space Program. Wow, I want Hideo Kojima to make Kerbal Space Program 2 in conjunction with Miyazaki. That's some dumb shit that just came out of my mouth right there. Team Charlie. Nope, I don't want to view your results. Cardboard box. Team Bravo. Nope, did anybody die? Skip, skip, skip. Transported to sickbay. Carl Gustav Fulton. Oh, yeah, I forgot about the Gustav Fulton. That thing is money. Look at all these people. There we go. Ration rank 3. Spicy curry rank 2. Mate T. Chubalicious asks, have you ever tried cold brew coffee? Yes, Starbucks has this crazy cold brew coffee. I think it's a little, I've tried it and I'll drink it. I think it's a little too strong for me, to be honest, because it tends to wreck up my tummy a lot more than the other stuff does. So go ahead and get all these out of the way. Boop. Love box. And how much money do I have left? Strike marker, grenade. What is that? 1911. I'd rather have grenades. All right. So, let's go blow that big motherfucker up. Okay. Do you let your dog sleep in your bed? Sometimes.
Snake.
Sometimes. Not always, but, you know, from time to time, I do. Okay, jungle jeans. Okay, no, that's not what I want. I want the... Which one did I bring?
Survival.
Oh, okay, so it's just all those now. All right, fine. 60. Gustav. Carl Gustav. Chaff is always good. Grenades. We could bring a little supply marker just in case we run out of stuff. Ration, curry, tortilla chips, Walkman. I'm going to need a shield. Sonic Eye, box tank. Assassin box. Binos, Walkman, ID card. Okay, we'll go with that. Boom. Boom.
Whew, boy.
My dog is he's pretty good. He's pretty bad. He's pretty awesome. When was the last time I had a Slurpee? Ooh, it's been a while. I don't do the sugary stuff anymore. All right, here we go. I got to think about, I've forgotten how you do this fight. You've got to get him to, you got to get him to drop the ladder.
If anybody can handle something this big, it's you, boss.
Where's the ladder on this motherfucker?
Get out of there. Run. Tidy won't do anything against a gun like that.
It's not on this side. That's, oh, boy. Yeah, whoa. All right, here we go. Let's see. Where do I need to be shooting you to make this work? Carl Gustav, you're... Yeah. Good lord. I'm so weighed down with things. Oof, oof, oof. Remember doing this mission a whole bunch of times to get parts for my own Metal Gear. Man, this thing is rough. Probably shooting it right in the wrong place. I'm moving it. I can only go so fast. Oh, I'm out of rounds. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Try it the old-fashioned way. Uh-oh. Ow. Uh-oh, shit. I do not want to be down here. Yeesh. Good lord, he's so slow. He's so slow, you guys. Okay. Here we go. Fucking run, run, snake! Here we go. Fire! Fire! Ow. Look at the way he rolls. It's like he would have to roll intentionally to roll that many times before coming to a stop. Okay, okay, okay. That's enough. Fucking Metal Gear jerk off. Go, 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 go. Eat a little curry. Uh-oh. I don't know if I'm doing this the right way. Oh, shit. Go, run. Faster, faster. I can't remember if I'm supposed to concentrate on this thing, and then that's what drops down the little dealy bob and lets me get on there, or whether it's something else. I do need to get some more ammo, though. Almost fully out. Okay, that's as good a time as any to throw some stuff. All right, here we go. Supply marker. Oh, not the main cannon again. Can I hide behind this, the main cannon? Don't blow up my supplies. Oh, nope. Can't hide behind that. Okay. It just blows it up. Shit. Tell me that you guys sent some ammo and not just curry. There we go. Oh, shit. Okay. Stop. Stop shooting. Stop shooting me. Stop. It's really annoying. Okay. Carl Gustav. Jeff, would you ever date a country girl? Sure, man. I don't have any standards. No, that's not true. I've actually done a few country girls in my time. And, yeah, I don't have a problem with that. As long as, like, it's not really important to her that I listen to country music because, you know, as Liz Lemon would say, that's a bit of a deal breaker. You know, I think this thing is having, like, an aneurysm. Oh, yeah, it's getting ready to have a big old aneurysm. La 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 la. I think. TR Cocoon. Oh, come on, just hold still. There we go. Jostle that. There we go. Yeah. Here we go. Boom, boom, boom. Al Diablo, I don't generally listen to country music. It's not something that I'm totally against, but it's kind of like got to be in the right mood. That's right. I don't know why you'd put a ladder on the side of your super death machine, but I appreciate it, whoever built this thing. Shut up, Otacon Huey-con. Uh-oh. Okay. Fucking hell. Ow. Wait, hold on. I can, like, chaff these bitches. And I can just huck grenades at them all day long. Haha, look at you. You're all messed up now. All messed up. Don't know what's going on. Oh, God damn it. Chaff, 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 chaff. You're shooting yourself. Quit shooting yourself. Quit shooting yourself. Why are you shooting yourself? Shit, I am almost totally out of health items. You use these tortilla chips. Alright, where's my Gustav at? God damn this thing. God damn this thing. Ugh. Shitty. Oh, no! Ow, ow, ouchie. Okay, well, this is a good opportunity for me to get some supplies. I'm gonna throw two of them, actually. Oh, no. Okay. You stupid robot. Oh, shit. Okay, maybe not so stupid. Maybe not so stupid. Would I consider making Sunday streaming longer by an hour? I don't know, man. We're pretty exhausted by the time. Like, today, after I get done with this, I've got a... Oh, shit. No, 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 no. Uh-oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. I'm dead. Eat all the tortilla chips. All the tortilla chips. Okay, go, go. Shit. Nope. Oh. Ooh, Dark Souls! Ha ha! Okay, come on. Come on, come on, come on. Shoot this motherfucker. Come on, keep shooting him, keep shooting him, keep shooting him. Oh, fuck. Here, I'll move over to this side. Maybe they won't hit me over here. Ow. Okay, goddammit. I gotta retreat soon. Nope, I gotta go get some more curry. Ah, crap!
No! Snake! Son of a bitch. A son of a bitch.
Okay, all right, let's do this. I think I got this down now. Nah, we got this time, guys. Snake! Oh shit! Ow! Or maybe not. Now I'm gonna be a lot more liberal with my supply requests than I was last time. I'm gonna try to stay the hell away from some of these things. All right, here we go. Boosh. What? Go. There's another bar. Whoa. Nope, not squat. I wish they'd refine the controls on this just a little bit on the PlayStation 3 version. I mean, all the select a weapon and stuff is fine. It's just that there's some stuff that's just a little bit awkward. Like, you have to hold down a button to lay down on the ground, and, like, you don't go into cover like you do in the other versions. I wish that they would have done a little bit more refining of that. Chaff! Don't need it. Got the chaff. Blah, 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 blah. Ha ha, you're confused. I think I'm just going to stay down here the entire time until it's one bar left. Get some. Oh, shit. Oops. Please don't shoot me. Go. Snake. Use the ladder, Snake. Spark says, do I have any theories about Phantom Pain? I read that one, and it was like, if that turns out to be true, I'm going to be kind of upset. So I'm trying to kind of keep all of what I've read to myself and kind of just go with what I know, which is real hard because I know that, you know, there's a lot of people who want me to, like, know everything about every game, and I like to be surprised, so it's this weird thing where it's like I kind of want to avoid some of, like, the in-depth, like, discussions of stuff so that I can just play the game and you know what's going to happen, which I know, you know, as we've talked about just ad nauseum, I know there's plenty of people out there who don't care if their movie is 100% new, who don't really care about spoilers, but I do still, so. And I don't think that that's irrational or jerky or anything. Okay, God damn it, dude. Yeah, I'd really not like to not be destroyed. Oh, wow. Eat chef, stupid robot. I got some Gustav rounds here, and I'm going to use them. We'll do another lore podcast with Nick once we played through the stuff. Maybe. I mean, you know, it's funny. When we did the E3 podcast and I misidentified Kazuhira in the trailer as Gene, and everybody was just like, that's not Gene! How can you call yourself a Metal Gear fan? I really need to kind of go back and refresh myself on some of this stuff because not all of it is able to you know, live forever in my brain. Ooh. Stop it. There we go. Am I going to see Deadpool when it comes out? Probably. Oh, shit. That was a bad one. What are you doing? Just showing. Shut up, Kaz. What do you think of Batman, Ben Affleck as the definitive Batman? according to WB. I think that WB can say whatever they want to, but the definitive Batman is the Batman that is Batman in all of our hearts and minds. You know, whoever that is for you. But you can spend all day long telling me what to do, lady. I know what I'm doing. Oh, shit. Uh-oh. Ow. That's a little low. So it looks like my primary mistake was crawling up on top of that thing in the first place. Get some more Gustav. Come on. Come on, bring me the Gustavs. One fun run, I know that, but last time when I went up there, those guns cut me to shreds, so I'm gonna get him down to one sliver of health before I roll up there. Oh, God. Oh, my God. That was just a swing and a miss. So, a fan of the Man in Black, Johnny Cash. Am I a fan of Johnny Cash? I think he's good. Jason is definitely... would definitely be the bigger Johnny Cash fan than I am. Alex asking if I had a girlfriend and she was cheating on me with a girl, what would your reaction be and what would you do? Well, I kind of see cheating as cheating, so I'd probably, you know, have to have a conversation about that, and I'd be inclined to probably break up with her because girl or dude or whatever, it's cheating. And I think the cheating to me is more about, like, you know, like not being able to trust a person or being, you know, having them, you know, abuse your trust than it is about the sex of the person that they're cheating on you with. Okay, here we go. I know what it is. I've already done this twice, Kaz. You have to tell me. Okay, come on. Open. Oh, God damn it. Come on. Open, open, open. There we go. Hoo-ah. Jeff, do you like Leah Turner? Is that McFly's mom from Adventures in Babysitting?
I know
about pulling all the unlocked memory boards out. I mean, you know, hey, Raven Strom, like, I'm not going to stand here and tell people that, like, if I was dating a woman and she wanted to date a woman, right, and we talked about it, that I wouldn't be, like, I wouldn't be for that by default, but I wouldn't be against it as an idea depending on the person and blah, 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 right? That's, like, one of those big old complex things that I would hate to try to, like, say, like, well, this is the hard and fast rule for that. So, yeah, I mean, you know, if you've got that kind of relationship, great. But I don't think it's something I could say, like, in an abstract, just like, well, yes, I would be fine with this or with that. So. There we go. Got all of your clock radios. And I'm going to take this one. Aw. Boom. You know, we could have shot that if that was the... No, dude, take it to the moon. Take it to Jewel. That thing's got enough Delta V. You can get there, Snake. Go, Snake. Boop, 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 boop. I love these little cutscenes where he blows up this giant tank and he's just like, well, enough of that. Go in here. Jeff, can you still not close? Well, Loco Steve, you know the answer to that. Yes, still can't close.
Oh, shit.
All right, what do we got here? B. What a crock of shit. B. That was like A++. Oh shit, I think I might have enough parts to start building my own Metal Gear. Let's see. see what we got. S-Audio, anybody can close in The Witcher 3. That's not really difficult. Look at all this stuff. So combat parameters. Got some Zeke scraps. So, yeah, it's sad. You can't really do all that much with this, but you can actually build your own Metal Gear in this game. So I got my walk unit equipped. I got my power unit equipped. All right, so it's got... I don't have any legs. I don't have enough leg parts yet. I don't have any head parts yet. And then you've got, like, the radome. Ah, I got a radome. Jetpack, got that. I don't have whatever that is. And a railgun. Man, all I need is just a little bit of head and leg parts. And then I can paint this motherfucker. And I can make it... pink! Pink-ass Metal Gear. Boom. That is solid. That's scarier than just about any other Metal Gear that's out there. Orange? Yellow. Yeah, pink and yellow. All right. Boom, boom, boom. Jeff, what are your thoughts on Rosie O'Donnell? Daisy Krogan, I don't have that many thoughts on Rosie O'Donnell. I'm going to be real up front with you. I don't really have good thoughts. I don't really have bad thoughts. I just don't really have any thoughts whatsoever. Okay, what do we got here? Strike markers. 41 M10. Strike. Which one is this? No, I think I want... Yep. Oh, damn it. Oh, so close. Okay, we'll go with... C4 is useful from time to time. And how about... That's it. Yep, how about that's it? How do my outer ops do? Who are you voting for this year, Jeff? Well, I'm not telling you guys. That's between me and the democratic system. I am not going to endorse, you know, a candidate or not a candidate. Probably not so much Donald Trump. I mean, you know, not really a big fan of them business honkies, the business folks in the first place. So, probably not, but you know. All right, here we go. We should see if there's anybody who wants to join the team. Yes, I'm writing myself in. That's a good answer, Ace of Card. I'm just going to vote Jason Murphy.
Huh. Looks like our reputation is spreading.
Okay, start mission. If Trump wears a Loco Steve shirt, will you lead towards his direction? If Donald Trump has a Loco Steve shirt, I'm gonna be calling his office to ask him where the shit he got it. Because it means that one of you guys mailed Donald Trump your Loco Steve shirt. I know where every single Loco Steve shirt is. I mail every one of those out by hand individually. I'm pretty sure that if I would have written D. Trump on one of them, that I would have remembered that. Vote for John. Yeah. John's a pretty... A vote for John is a vote for awesome. And think of how many different hairstyles he'll have while he's in office. That'd be awesome. And Rage Slick can be like... I could be like national like hot dog advisor or something. Or national like Casual Friday... Secretary of Casual Friday or something like that. Are you still planning on getting the Retro Mario amiibo? You know, Lieutenant Commander Armstrong, that kind of falls under that whole, like, if I've got to, like, work really hard to get to give somebody my money for something, I start to get really disinclined to do it. Like, if I go to a store, you know, if I go to a GameStop and pick one up, maybe, but it's got to be the sort of thing where it's like, I got to just, like, fucking get in there, you know, like, that's, if I got to pre-order, essentially, or do anything. That's what I'm saying. If I have to do anything, I don't. I got a lot to do already. I don't know if I'm really into that. Give me some hints about games and guests next week. Oof. No. Jeff, if you won the lottery, would you quit Rage Select? Hell no, Loco Steve. I'd just hire a whole bunch more people. I would just get myself a big house and a podcasting throne with a chalice on it. Oh, this level. God, you know what? The audio mix in this game is awful. It just sounds like everybody is right next to me the entire time. So let's go ahead and just... These guys just have t-shirts on. They don't even have helmets on. You guys are terrible at this. This is the point where I get seen, right? Pull all these motherfuckers up into the stratosphere. How are they even going to get out? Look, there's a roof on this place. Where are they going to go? They're just going to get all, like all up in the corner?
That elevator should take you underground. To use the elevator, press the action button in front of the switch. Fulton recovery helicopter is complete. Fulton recovery subject confirmed onboard helicopter.
Maybe headphones aren't surround sound. That's entirely possible. These headphones are just the two-channel headphones that I use for, like, Skype and recording the podcast and stuff like that. It's possible that maybe the game is trying to send, like, a surround sound signal, and I'm just not my headphones aren't able to pick it up. And this level. See ya! See ya! I like how happy the prisoners are to get Fulton out. Woohoo! Ah, there you go. Is there anybody else still standing? I don't know. Need to get that Soliton radar. Don't think Jeff is mean enough to fire people. There's like some jokes I can make there, but I feel like if I made them that eventually people would take them seriously and I would just be like, oh, okay.
Fulton recovery helicopter is complete.
There we go. And then you go, and then we're done, right? Woohooey! Isn't that all of you guys? Jeff, are you going to get Mafia 3 when it comes out? Sure. I mean, you know, unless it's something like a teeny tiny and small. Like, most of the time, for most games, you're going to see me get them when they come out. Oh, shit, I forgot there's, like, four levels here. Yeah, that's why they were so easy to pick off. Boop.
What is it?
Yeah, you come see what's up with your boy. Uh-oh.
Freeze.
Haha. You got punked out. Could you not... God damn it. Do you not have any, like, Fultons that I can have? I guess not. Take this guy. Get him the shit out of here. I think most of these guys have, like, good intelligence scores. Is that guy going to come over here? What happened to your friend? Where the hell are you going? Are you leaving this area? Wow, what is that guy doing? I'm going to shoot him in the face. But he's acting real weird. Okay. Beady, beady. I like this tense-ass music. I like all of the Metal Gear soundtrack. People ask a lot of times about, like, oh, shit, about, you know, Jeff, like, what's your favorite gaming music? And this stuff definitely ranks up there. It's just real solid and atmospheric.
Who's that? Enemies close by.
No way, dude. You didn't see me. You didn't see there was nothing. Oh, shit. Maybe they saw me. They might have seen me, you guys. Oh, shit. Quit. Sounded like he said eliminate all hope. Like fucking 40K Space Marines. Okay. Oh, shit. They're just on high alert. Yeah, some of these guys have freaking shotguns. Freeze, bitch.
Freeze.
Is there some plans in here? Oh, hell. Oh, hell. I think if I go down here, maybe? Yeah, there we go. This guy, if he wasn't wearing his sunglasses inside. Oh, Lazy Croaking, I'm not really super up on that one. I didn't see what she said. It didn't filter through to my stuff last week.
Freeze. Freeze.
I'm sure it was pretty terrible, though. But then again, you know, you've got that whole, like, making celebrities out of people who shouldn't be celebrities in the first place thing. Most of these guys are useless. I thought I heard a prisoner. I always like to get them if I can. Do you imagine do a midnight or launch stream for the Phantom Pain? That is actually a very real possibility. The Bloodborne stream that we did, you know, because Max Payne or Mad Max comes out that same week, so there's a good possibility that you know, we may do a midnight stream to kind of just get a bit more coverage of Metal Gear before or when it comes out. I mean, I can't tell. Like, I know that. Like, Jason could not care less about Metal Gear and is all up into Mad Max. Alex asks, what are your thoughts on Zombie U coming to other systems? I'm all in favor of it because it's the summertime drought and I don't have a hell of a lot to play. Here we go. Jeff, why is Kanye West a genius and when will he be on the dojo? I don't know why he's a genius, and he won't return my calls, so I can't get him on the dojo. Let's see. Yeah, I mean, S-Audio, well, see, okay, S-Audio, I don't know. I mean, I don't know what we're going to do for Phantom Pain Mad Max. Initiate. Like, I'd almost rather get somebody that was more of a fan of the Metal Gear franchise. And then let Jason be on Mad Max, where he would just be happier. That rather than force him to be on a game that I know that he's not a big fan of and doesn't really know anything about either, so. I mean, sometimes it's good to have the whole, like, the whole dichotomy of somebody who's interested and somebody who's not interested, but a lot of times, I don't know. Yeah, a lot of times it's difficult to. I don't know. I feel like people have a better time when we're all just having a great time. I mean, I know that there's a lot of people who like Grant hates JRPGs, and I know they like to see him suffer. But I feel like that's good for a few, a few episodes. But it's like not the sort of thing that I would want to waste on Metal Gear because that's a pretty big release. But
do you have regrets?
Regrets
about your final?
Well, Illegal Swede, you know, when people talk about Illegal Swede says, I don't see how someone could watch the trailers for the Phantom Pain and not be even minutely interested. I mean, I think that there's, like, Metal Gear is kind of like Dark Souls in that it's got this reputation for being, like, super convoluted and super story-heavy, and everybody's like, oh, man, the cutscenes are so long. There's, like, six-hour cutscenes. It's like there's, like, one two-hour cutscene in that game. But, like, they love to clickbait that and make, you know, having a little bit of story in your game seem like just a completely unreasonable thing. I like the cinematic nature of the cutscenes in the Metal Gear franchise.
You're not the boss.
But I feel like a lot of people, they think that the concept is silly. They think that the... Yeah, I don't know.
Showed the same response back at It's an honor to meet you again, big boss. I've seen that coyote before.
Oh, shit.
What's the name? Lobo.
Lobo. Like the main man? Like Hulk Hogan?
Selena Yarsk, 10 years ago.
Yeah, I don't know, whatever.
The operation to eliminate the traitor. I planned the whole thing.
You son of a bitch!
Shouldn't suit like you be back in Langley. What the hell are you doing here? It's what the CIA does best. Ensure people in Minot keep their mouths shut.
I guess like they just found the picture of the most grinningest evil motherfucker that they could. Dr. Fun Boogie asks, "What's the saddest thing to happen to you?" I'm not really looking to crawl down that particular mental path. Oh, yeah, I think that Hulk Hogan. It's a shame that he's a jerk. I don't think you should use that kind of language about people. I mean, I think that it kind of belies an inherent judgment about people that is kind of shitty. Sweet Jordy asked me if I knew what Bane posting was, and I did not. And I couldn't tell you what Hulk Hogan's future is going to be like, but I don't know. When the commander of a Russian sub refused an order to launch. Oh shit, we're almost out of time. I'm going to skip this cutscene. Uh-oh. Going for Strangelove. R1. Boom. Sideways. Boom. R1. Boom. Sideways. So, give me a hug. See, he's not like Loco Steve. He uses more machine guns than Loco Steve. Wah. R1. Hooah. Around the corner. R1. Grab you. Bam. Throw you down on the ground. Down on the ground. Now grab her and throw her on the ground too. Ha ha. Got your key card.
Take him away.
Have I ever considered advertising Rage Select on Google? I'm not sure. I'm not entirely sure what that would be, what that would entail, just buying, like, some cross-posting Google AdSense time. I suppose. I don't know. I'm trying to kind of get us to a point. I mean, once, like I said, when we get everybody firing on all cylinders, I'm kind of thinking that we're gonna have time to maybe do things that people have been asking for, like bring back reviews or maybe some of the shows that we've had to kind of put on hiatus, but we'll see. We'll see how it ends up. All right, here we go. Team Charlie's back. I don't care about you, Charlie. Parameters all went up. Great. Cardboard boxes. Alpha's back. Nope, I don't care. Oh, no, Wagtail died. And we got some Choco Chip naked uniforms. Bravo. Oh, no, goddammit. I don't care about this. Yeah, you have a helicopter. You're going to beat them. Pilot Whale and Horseshoe Crab are going to beat Leech and Cod? Is that guy's name Cod? Fritillery? Where the hell? Do they just, at Konami, do they just like have a book of, the book of weird-ass animals? All right. Let's see here. All right, you know what? We've got a few more minutes left, so I'm going to jump into whatever the next mission is. Guns blazing, and y'all can tell me. Oh, torture chamber escape. Haha, okay. Is this the one where you have to bring somebody? No, okay, this is the one with Snake. All right, well, folks, if you guys want to throw in some questions into this chat, I'm going to try to sneak out of here. It just sounds like he's gargling. Listen to it. It sounds exactly like... Pepper Jack or cheddar? I'm not such a big cheese person, but probably take Pepper Jack. How come you never play original Red Dead on live streams? Why do you play the DLC? Well, Red Dead is... There's a lot of weird legality involved with some of the more high-profile things that we've done, and we'll see how that all ends up working out. I got my shirt off. She gave it to me. Crazy lady. You're crazy. Was not sheer coincidence. Better Happy Madison movie, Bucky Larson or Pixels? I have not seen either one. Diver 216. Oh, here we go. More gargling. Ready? Lacey Krogan, I'm not getting into the answers to those questions. That's not something I can talk about. I'm not saying any more about the what I just said. So you guys can move on, or I can talk about Pepper Jack cheese more. She just got like fluorescent light tubes. Burf. I do hate you. But even you must understand how I feel. What's your favorite video so far that you made? Ah, Al Diablo, that's hard to answer. There's so many of them that are so good. You know, it's funny. I thought that the part two of Lost Dimension that we did last week with Brian was freaking hilarious. We had this, like, Seinfeld bit and this, like, talk about Back to the Future that I thought was really good, and yet people are just, like, just didn't really watch it. Jeff, online dating or bar scene or fuck dating, it sucks. I don't like dating, but I understand that's because of my own horrible insides of my own brains, so... Glow sticks. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, Al Diablo, I have fun making a lot of these videos, which sometimes is a real drag because not many people watch them. Or we get, like, you know, fewer views on stuff like King's Quest, where I thought it was really good, but other people just didn't really care for it. Yeah, Life is Strange was really fun. St. Helian, go do a search on our YouTube page for Lucius 2 on the Dojo, and you'll see... a whole two-part video that Richard Whitaker and I made for the horror game Lucius 2. I mean, I just, you know. Will you read Ronald Reagan-themed slash fiction at the next Ragecast? You'd have to ask Jason about that. He's the one who's got Charles St. Charles's phone number. Charles St. Charles keeps me away. Oh, no, no, no. Oh, God, I'm not. Why not just stop? Because if I do, the game is over, lady. Will he be back, St. Helian? I don't know. I just don't have as much contact with Richard as I do as I had with some of the other folks. And he was great, but I think I would probably have him on, like, mostly for horror games more than anything else. Jeff, what movie is most like Rage Select? Fight Club is the answer to that, especially the beginning where Edward Norton can't sleep. That's very apt. I was just crouching here. Can I lay down on this bed for just a second? I'll get all the ideas that I want, you idiot. So, Jeff, Life is Strange sequential. Please say yes, please, says Dr. Von Bookie. Dr. Von Bookie, as I've said to almost everybody in the whole entire world, isn't Life is Strange isn't even all out yet, right? It's still sequential, and it's still going on right now. So, wait, what is going on here? Uh-oh. Let's see. Oh. Okay. Get this guy down here. Huh? What? Ooh. I have no idea why Spartacus Legends. Yeah, I think that Spartacus thing happened because not many people were doing videos of that game, and that's why it ended up getting more views than it really should have. Whata! Jump down on the ground! Next! Jeff, do you like to cha-cha? Jeff, I don't really dance very well or really much at all. So I have nothing intrinsically against the cha-cha, the tango waltz or the rumba. So, you know, but I just don't really do it myself. I look like a damn fool. What do I think of Ronald Reagan? Not much. Again, have I ever seen a film called The Good, the Bad, and the Weird? Yes, I thought it was good. I thought it was also bad, and I thought it was a little bit weird. Jeff, Shawshank Redemption or The Green Mile? I think they both have their merits. I think Shawshank ends up making me more emotional than The Green Mile does, even though they're both quite good stories. I find the supernatural nature of The Green Mile to be a little bit, makes it just to me a little bit less affecting as a movie. I said, Jeff, don't dance. He just pulls up his pants and do the rock away. I'm sure that's like a song that I don't understand. favorite movie in the Man with No Name trilogy. This is somewhat controversial, but I'm a huge fan of For a Few Dollars More. I like the kind of old Bounty Hunter, Young Bounty Hunter, Lee Van Cleef stuff. I think that at the end when they have the music box playing and then it turns into like the big symphonic version, that it's like really good. St. Helena says, Jeff, where do you get all your video game art? Not all of them are game screenshots. Do you get special permission? I actually spent an awful lot of time on that. Sometimes they're screenshots. Most of the time they are screenshots. It's just I have to look for them. Every so often, like with whatchamacallit, Here's the Storm, like I'll make my own thing if possible. But for the most part, not tortilla chips, not ration. Where's my key card? Oh, okay. I guess I don't have one. But I do spend time like thinking about that and trying to find like the best screenshot that kind of fits within the parameters of what I want it to be. But for the most part, they're all screenshots. Sometimes you can get good stuff off of like a press kit if you go to the website for whatever the game is and you look for a press kit. Better Kingpin, Michael Clark Duncan or Vincent D'Onofrio? I think they're entirely different Kingpins. It'd be like, I liked D'Onofrio's Kingpin, but I also think that Michael Clark Duncan does a really good job. So, if only we had a gif of Jeff dancing. If you had that, I would have to ask how you got it, and then I would have to figure out which one of my friends had let you do that, or taken that picture, because you don't see Jeff dance that often, if ever. Well, you little rascals, it's 5 past, so we're all done. I'm going to go ahead and wrap it up. I know we started a little late today, and I know that we didn't play Viva Pinata. Sorry about that. You know, Kayla was sick, and John and Amanda are out. And so I think that it was just me and you guys, but we had a good time, I think. And so it's probably going to be a couple hours before I can get the podcast up. I have to edit it myself this week, so I gotta. Oh yeah, there is. I guess there is some Just Dance videos. That's true. You guys do have video of me dancing. That's the worst. You have a video of Grant and I doing our duet to What Does the Fox Say and my sweaty armpits. So thanks everybody for watching, and I'm going to go ahead and sign off. I'm sorry I didn't get to everything. Check back here in about an hour for the podcast, and then check back here later tonight or early tomorrow, depending on if you're going to sleep, for part one of Ragecast 4, because I've got those uploading to YouTube right now, and as soon as they get up there, I'm going to start releasing them over the course of Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. So check back on the Ragecast 4 page. You should start seeing that I'm going to post the YouTube videos up there. Thanks you guys so much. I will catch you next week. Good night.